the mind of a boat builder. Maybe you're spending a lot of time looking at websites and pictures and plans, and your head is just full of things, the wood, the material, the engines. Take a look at what somebody's going through who's already started the project, is moving down that path, and maybe you'll get a better feel for what's ahead.
I'm Scott, living upstate New York, just west of Rochester, 43 years old, and I recently retired from law enforcement.
I started when I was 14 being a fire explorer at a volunteer fire department, and we kind of learned the ropes in the fire service. I became a volunteer firefighter, and then I took a job as a 911 operator, and then a police dispatcher, and then from police dispatching I went to working in law enforcement or local sheriff's office. That's a tough one, and I don't know necessarily if I have a hero. I mean, I admire a lot of qualities and a lot of different people. You know, I mean, I admire like the writings of Thomas Jefferson. I admire the mindset of people like Mike Rowe. But there's a lot of qualities that I take, that I look up to or admire. Or if you want to call it heroic, or they're my hero, people who are passionate, authentic, and honest. You know, I mean, somebody who's not afraid to say, I don't know. You know, and it was funny, we were at a doctor's appointment this morning for my son, and, you know, I've spent, you know, we have some heredity health issues in the family. I've spent a lot of time in emergency departments, you know, the fire service and police, met a lot of doctors. I really admire doctors, the amount of dedication, the skill set, the calmness, you know, that's something that I look up to. We're building a 41-foot full displacement trawler yacht. A trawler yacht concept being, you know, slow and steady, but with great range. It's a very modest beam, so it's very fuel efficient. We only are going to need about 85 horses to push it. Our hull speed is probably around 7 or 8 knots, but we'll probably cruise at 5 or 6 to get our best mileage, you know, our best range. Built out of wood, designed by George Bueller from his Diesel Duck line, and you know, George designed for the average person, the home builder, to make it within the reach of the, you know, average handy person. There's a lot of straight lines, a lot of simple angles. It's very approachable, very doable for, you know, a woodworker or a carpenter or a framer or something like that. I've been a woodworker for probably about 20 years. You know, my father's a retired city firefighter, so, you know, all the firemen always had a side job. You know, his side job was buying houses and fixing them up. So we were always renovating something. You know, we were always at our house, you know, at his house, we're always building something. And so then when I got my own house, when I was an adult, you know, and the first thing I did was start building a shop. And so that became, you know, I did enjoy it in high school too. I mean, they don't even do it anymore, but there was like an advanced woodworking class that I took in high school that I loved. You know, I wish they would have made it clear that that was a viable career opportunity back then, but it really wasn't made clear to me that way. So, you know, regardless, but I enjoyed it very much, and I knew once I had my own place, I'd want my own shop. So I began woodworking, and then wood was the natural, I understood it. I have access to it, I have the tools to work it, and I'm familiar with it. And it smells good. Well, we've never owned a boat before. I've certainly never built a boat before. When I kind of got a little funk with the woodworking, and we'd recently bought a jet ski for a very small lake cottage that we share with our family. My wife and I were like, wow, this is great. You know, this would be great if we had a boat. And so I somehow stumbled onto wooden boats, and I actually started building, I'm still working on it, a 14 and a half foot runabout, a wooden runabout. But as I was building that, I'm like, you know, I'm gonna have to put 10 grand into this thing. And what I really want is something that we could live on. So I started looking more, I stumbled on different designs. I came upon the Diesel Duck, read his George Bueller's books. I'm like, holy cow, this guy's talking my tune. And so then we got started building it, or we got started thinking about it, and I'm like, you know what, if we're gonna get a big boat, and I don't know anything about boats, I want to know how this whole thing goes together. So when the boat is done and something breaks, and it will break, I'll be able to say, I know where that pipe goes, I know where that wire goes, I know why I did this here. I mean,
it won't be a mystery. It'll be, it might not be perfect, but it'll be my imperfections, and I'll know where everything is.
You can definitely buy cheaper. And I've actually been on like forums, like Wooden Boat Forum, and you know, you'll start talking about you're building a boat, and you know how it is with the internet. You know, there are people that tell you how stupid you are and how, you know, this is a dumb idea. Yeah.
They say, well, why don't you buy one? You can do it for cheaper. Well, you know, what's the fun in that? You know, I mean, the fun, a lot of it is the building process. I mean, this is, you know, my wife really is looking forward to the joy of travel, and whereas I'm, you know, really enjoying the building of it and then the maintenance and upkeep of it once it's done. I mean, there's no fun in just buying. Once we decided what boat we were going to build, then we needed a place to build it. So we had to build our boat shed. And that is based off a greenhouse plan that we just kind of expanded a little bit. And that was a really fun project. That took a couple months, and we built that for less than $2,000. That was in 2016. But we actually started work on the boat, lofting out the keel, in January of 2017. I haven't kept track of all my hours that I've worked on it. It's all only been part-time while I was working. Gosh, you know, it's hard to guess. You know, I mean, you know, you're talking about maybe 15, 16 hours a week, you know, a couple hours after work, you know, a few hours on the weekends. It's hard to gauge. But so we've been, you know, going at it hard since January of 2017. Now that I'm retired, I'm probably doing at least 30, maybe more. Just a couple more weeks. You know how it is. People ask me that, how long is it going to take? I don't know. I mean, I like to say 5 years. Money's an issue, and it is for any project, no matter how big or small. And we're kind of building paycheck to paycheck. But time is on my side, and I'd rather have it done right than done fast. So it's going to be done when it gets done. I mean, we'll enjoy the process, and it'll be done when it's done. I've never built a boat before. I've never owned a boat before. This is an all new experience for us. Obviously, you know, I've had some experience doing woodworking and building furniture, you know, remodeling houses, just, you know, a little bit on the side, never professionally. So I think I'm pretty handy, but, you know, I'm no expert for sure. So boat building is an acquired skill. And like anything, it can be learned, though. I mean, like anything. how much is going to cost? How long is it going to take? I don't know. You know, I mean, cost-wise, I'm totally, totally guessing because I don't know anything about boats. You know, so when I say $80,000, $100,000, I'm not really sure. You know, wood is cheap. In the grand scheme of building, wood, plywood, cheap. The systems is where it's expensive. Tanks, engines, systems, radars, you know, bow thrusters. That's the expensive stuff. So I guess we're going to find out. Our payment is working paycheck to paycheck. It's kind of how George, the designer, George Buehler, talked about in his book that, you know, you set aside X amount of dollars from each paycheck and you put it in a kitty, and then when you need something, it's there and you go and you buy it. We're constantly on eBay, we're constantly on Craigslist, you know, we're always on the lookout for parts and spares or, you know, refurb or salvage. You do the best that you can. It has to be a priority in your life. I think we live pretty modestly otherwise, besides this crazy project, but it has to be a priority. We actually had a reporter come out to our house last summer to see the project. I had a friend in the media who saw the project on Facebook and sent him a link, and he came over so he wanted to see it. So they did a little news story. And as I was talking to him, you know, somewhere along the line, we as adults, you know, we stop dreaming, you know, because it's childish or frivolous, you know, and, you know, you sit around with your friends sometimes, especially when you're younger, and you say, you know what would be cool, you know what would be fun, and then you talk about it, and then you immediately start to come up with reasons to dismiss it, how it can't be done, it's impossible, it's a wasteful, whatever. So somewhere along the line, as adults, we stop dreaming, and life's no fun when you don't have a dream, when you trudge to work every day and you come home and you live for, you know, your 2 days off, or you live for your 2-week vacation in the summer. That's not living. And you have to have a purpose, and you have to have a drive and a dream. And when I started working on this boat, when I started working on the little boat, I was like, wow, this is pretty cool. And then when I started thinking that I could build something bigger that we could live on, you know, something that, you know, like we dreamed about as a young couple, saying, wouldn't it be nice to live on the water? You know, well, we'll probably never be able to afford a house on the water, but we could build a house that's on the water. And when we started to go down that path, I was like, this is what I was meant to do. This is what I was meant to do. And it just became clear. The video part, I started writing about it on the blog and on the website. And I was starting to get, you know, it wasn't overwhelming or anything, but I was getting feedback from readers or people on Facebook saying, you know, you should do a video series, you know. And they would say, look at Doug over at SV Seeker. You'll do videos and you'll get all the help you need. And I'm like, well, you know, okay, that's an idea. But then I started to look online for boat building videos, and I was like, well, George Bueller's been designing these diesel ducks for 20 years, and they're designed for home builders. There's got to be somebody else out there building a diesel duck, and there wasn't any. I couldn't find anybody else building a wooden duck. So as me, as who has no knowledge, no boating experience, no nothing, that was frustrating. So I was like, you know what? You know, you can talk the talk or you can walk the walk, so I'll do my own video, so when the next guy comes along, he'll, even if I'm doing it wrong, he'll say, oh, I won't do it that way, or he'll have a leg up and say, oh, that worked out really well. So it was kind of like, you know, you can shit or get off the pot, and so that's what we did. And then, you know, it's an evolution, the videotaping. I have no experience in video editing or shooting, or, you know, I just copy what I see on TV, I copy what I see in movies, and then you just try to replicate it at home. It definitely slows down the building process, the videotaping, because you're constantly changing the camera, you're constantly moving it around, you're setting up shots, you're trying to get things that are interesting. I would probably say, with editing, maybe 10 to 15% of my time is probably shooting, editing. I probably could be 10 to 15% faster if I wasn't shooting video. I use my primary camera as just a point and shoot kind of a Sony handheld video camera. I mean, it's decent, but it was only like $400. I bought it off eBay. Nothing complex there, very simple. I don't mess with the settings, autofocus. I wish I knew more about how to, you know, take different shots. Like if you watch like the Acorn Boys or you watch Leo, you know, I mean, those guys are artists with video equipment, and that's impressive. I admire them, but there's just too much to learn there. Our dream is to take it down south, probably like the intercoastal, maybe do the loop, and, you know, eventually after we do some voyaging, to have kind of a pattern where we winter in Florida and then summer up here in upstate New York on one of the Finger Lakes here where our cottage is. I grew up in a small town right on the Erie Canal. You know, it's in your backyard. We used to jump off the locks and into the canal when we were kids, you know what I mean? You don't realize that if you're on the Erie Canal, you can get anywhere in the world. You know what I mean? You can get out to blue water, you can travel around the world. And, you know, I never even knew that until about 3 years ago. And so, but, you know, you can get on that canal and then you can go up through the Great Lakes and then go down the Mississippi and then out into the Gulf and then around Florida and then back up the intercoastal and then through New York City and then back up to my hometown. You know what I mean? And that sounded really cool, like a really cool adventure with help close by. In case, you know, you're not too often in open water, except when you get into the Gulf. And then, you know, after we get a little voyaging out of our system, I think having a place to just be on the water in the nice, warm, sunny weather down there, I think that'll be fun. Most difficult part has been the language. Every specialty has its own language, whether it's music, medicine, or boat building, there's a language. And when people start talking about, you know, buttock lines and, you know, a chine, and, you know, I didn't know what any of these things meant or what they were supposed to do or how it fit. So you have to learn the language, but once you learn the language, things become clear. And it was, when I started building the little boat, that was kind of like my introduction to the language. And as I started to understand the language, I was better able to process the books that I was reading.
Because I mean, I'm a learner by touching, by putting my hands on it. It's hard for me to just do it all in theoretical or through books. You know, I have to do it myself.
You know, help comes in mysterious ways. We get, you know, people don't realize that sometimes, you know, the comments, whether they're on YouTube videos or on Facebook or somebody sends you an email, they do tip you off to, even people who are being dismissive or you know, trying to be, you know, poo-poo your party, sometimes they have valid points, you know, and sometimes they have valid considerations. So the help we get is varied, you know, from our online friends, we've met people, you know, a couple people in the business who have offered their advice and their support to help share our project online. I don't really, you know, I mean, I don't have a go-to guy. We're in the golden age of DIY. We really are. I mean, if you're into something, you can go online and you can find somebody else who's into it too. And, you know, given enough time and enough patience, you can find out pretty much anything that you need to find out. And through enough pictures and enough videos and enough reading, you know, you can learn a lot. I've had a few people offer to come out and help. I mean, actually, a couple weeks ago, we actually had some people who were up from Virginia to see their granddaughter graduate from college, and they wanted to stop by just to see the boat. And that was my first stranger visitor. And, you know, they were an older couple, but very nice, very impressed, and, you know, very supportive. It was a neat experience. I've never really given much thought to taking on help or bringing on help. I mean, if somebody called and said, hey, I'm going to be in Rochester, can I stop out and help you for a day? I mean, I would, of course, accept it. You know, and they could just send us an email at contact@cdreamerproject.com. That'd be fine. But, you know, we're the little kid in the YouTube spectrum. We're the little guys on the block. You know, we don't have the exposure some of the other channels do. I mean, the greatest challenge I've had, and we kind of touched on it earlier, was learning the language, was understanding the process of how a boat goes together. It's not a floating house. It's systems built on systems. And you have to understand that process to some extent to have any hope of success. In the short term, the greatest challenge right now is I'm really thinking about the diesel tanks and how to get, I plan to take a welding class in the fall so that I want to be able to weld up my own diesel tanks. That's, you know, specific what I'm concerned about. You know, long term, again, this is a very simple part of the boat building process. Framing, planking, you know, this is not rocket science. People could figure this out. But once we start getting into the nitty gritty of the drivetrain and systems, I have no experience in that, and that's going to be a challenge. It's going to be a lot of learning. My wife, she's my, I call her the Admiral. When I refer to her online, she referred to her as the Admiral. And, you know, I could, you know, we've been together for a long, long time, and we've had our, you know, ups and downs like any couple. And I've made lots and lots of mistakes, and I've done lots of things wrong. You know, she's not perfect, but she's a lot better than me. And she has never once questioned this process. You know, I mean, if anything, you know, she's more excited about it than me. You know, this is a girl from, you know, Annapolis, Maryland, whose grandfather was a Navy guy in World War II. You know, she grew up around boats. She grew up on Chesapeake Bay. You know, so she's excited about the water, and she has been nothing but supportive, and I think. You know, you can't do a project like this if your spouse or significant other is rolling their eyes every time you go out to the shop. You know, I mean, this is a huge undertaking of time and money, and if you don't have the support of your spouse or significant other, you're going nowhere. I would 100% do it again. If I had to do something differently, I would build a bigger boat ship. Again, this goes to what the hell do I know about boats, you know? I look at the plans say the boat's 41 feet long. I say, all right, I'll build a 45 feet long. You know, I got a couple feet on each end. Now, go big, go real big. Start today. My advice to you is if you're thinking about it, start today. And I mean, I'm not saying you got to go buy every piece, but I'm saying go
buy some piece of wood or steel or fiberglass.
We are not guaranteed anything in life. You're not guaranteed a number of days, and you cannot live your life saying, oh, when I retire or when this happens or when this kid goes to college or is done with college, you know, you've got to start moving towards it today, and make every day count. I don't want to sound like an after school special, but you know, I mean, you have to do something, and it can be a tiny little bit, but once you start taking one step, that's how it starts. Well, now that I'm concentrating on the build full time, I'm still getting up at the, you know, my normal time that I did when I was working. You know, I'm getting up at 5:36 in the morning. You know, I'll have a little breakfast, watch a little news. Summertime is rough because it's hot out. So, I mean, I'd rather work hard in the morning and then when the afternoon rolls around, take a break or go into the shop itself. The shop is a conditioned space. But, you know, so I'll get up, do my morning routine. I'm probably out working on the boat by 7:30, 8 o'clock in the morning. I try to game plan, you know, a couple days in advance, so I have a goal of what I'm trying to get done for this day and for the next day and the third day. And then, you know, you do your best. I mean, obviously, things don't always go how you planned. But you go out there and work for a few hours. The beauty is I'm my own boss, and when I want to take an hour and a half lunch, or if I want to go meet a friend for lunch, or if I'm burned out and I want to take a break and call it a day, I call it a day. You know, I mean, it's a nice problem to have.
I hope you found that enjoyable, and what Scott is doing is inspirational because, yeah, he doesn't really know all the things that are happening, but he knows he can figure them out, and that's kind of what boat building is all about. You got to, just like he said, you got to start. And if you'd like to help out with Scott's project, we have a coin that you can buy. It's a challenge coin. It sells for $20. $15 of that proceed goes directly to Scott and helping him build Henry Red. So help him out, give him a hand, and help him continue making videos, because who knows, maybe you'll be next. Our next video in this series will be Don and Sarah, who are building Lady Dew, a steel boat.